Good evening, everyone. I think before I start, I maybe should do some quick introductions. The MC today, who has been doing the presentation, the early overview presentation, she herself is a GPA scholar. She's still waiting for government to appoint her after coming back since December. And while waiting for government to appoint her, she decided to work for us a while back. Okay, today's topic, apologies for the spelling there. Seeking a fair and equitable system for Malaysian JPA scholarship. Okay, why did this issue come about? Actually, to be frank, last year, when I started an education blog way before I even joined politics. I've always been interested in education and scholarships and stuff. So I've always been monitoring it ever since 2005, 2006, 2007. Every year there are problems. And suddenly when I was looking out for problems in 2008, tada! Really tada! Couldn't find issues to... That time someone become politicians, don't want to whack government. Cannot find. And Simon, as I will show you later, Yang Zi said all the right things. Okay, although I don't agree with quota, but because they changed the quota to a 55-45 system, suddenly everyone managed to get their scholarship. No real cases of appeal. You don't hear the annual story. Last year, tada. Then this year, suddenly all come back again. Okay, so why did it come back? Okay, this is a song from Wee Ka Siong. I think we saw it today. SPM result 6A1482. Outcome overseas scholarship for engineering. Engineering, apparently, according to Tan Sri Ismail Adam yesterday when we met him, is the third or fourth most popular ranking in terms of cost, difficulty of getting a scholarship. Third or fourth highest. The highest is, of course, the medicine, then after that, you have got pharmacy and you have got something else before engineering. Okay? But SPM results 13A1s, 14A1s. Outcome, local matriculation. Local matriculation means you are on a dead end to local universities. Why? Because local matriculation is not recognized anywhere around the world. Okay, some universities recognize it, but most universities do not recognize local matriculation results. They recognize STPS, they recognize our unrecognized UEC system by the Chinese Independent School, but the overseas universities, by and large, do not recognize the local matriculation program. Okay. So once you are offered local matriculation, it's a dead end to a local university. So all these 13A1, 14A1 students are extremely disappointed because yes, I get a scholarship, local, but I will not have any chance, even on my own, if I would take up the offer to go overseas. Because after, even if I get excellent results during my matriculation, I will have a lot of problems trying to get a place in an overseas university. 280 straight A1 students need to submit appeal. This was the statistics provided by Wee Ka Siong himself. 280 this year. So we are not talking about a couple of students who did badly during their interviews who got picked up. This is 280 straight A1 students. Okay, straight A1 students meaning usually 9 A1 and above. And this number doesn't include people who got 12 A1, 2 A2s. Doesn't even include those. So a couple of hundred more are people who got 10 A1s, 1 A2, and they are not straight A1 students, okay, that still need to submit appeal. Where is the problem? Where is the problem? We saw the criteria just now. 20% merit, 60% by race, 55, 45, or 60, 40, whatever it is. But still, even if you by race, these people are well within the top brackets, should be able to get the scholarship. Mathematically, they should still be within the range to get a scholarship, whatever the criteria. Why is it that they are left out? What happened? This is from a student who blogs and who writes excellent English. I got a comment from him. The full text, I'll read a bit of it, but this is excerpt from the text. You know, his English is impeccable. I mean, this is someone that you read and you know that his thinking is mature, although it's a bit melodramatic because he's still 18-year-old or 17 years old, so give him a chance. No, he said, the truth is finally out. I failed. Yes, F-A-I-L-E-D, failed in my JPA scholarship application.
I got 11 A1s and I didn't get JP. Here are my feelings. Here's my feelings. I typed in my IC and there, smack, a cold, heartless, cruel Tidak Berjaya. That could mean the strongest of hearts. A word that drags the most lifting spirits like a wonton brick into the harrowing trenches of sorrow, sadness, grief, pain, disappointment, and bitterness. Believe me, I feel your pain. A few more paragraphs like that and you feel the world. You feel the world has collapsed upon your shoulders. You feel all your back-breaking and brain-numbing efforts are being flushed down the drain. You feel utterly unsatisfied to be labelled the person who failed to get JPA, which would be the scorching topic of chatterbox uncles and aunties for years to come. You feel you want to scream out when you are being shoved into the group of people who are deemed ordinary, who go to a local university, especially when you got a stack full of A's. No? And he went on a few paragraphs later, the scar is a deep wound that is hard to heal. In fact, it may never heal at all. But when an entrepreneur fails, he wears the failure like a badge of honor. He even quoted Michael Jordan. I fail, and fail many times in my life. And that is why I succeed. So it's the type of response, the type of writing that you expect of a very intelligent young man. It's not your typical man, person who can get 12 A's and then when you ask him questions, don't know how to answer. You know, cannot talk type of person. Yes, it's a bit, Roma. your hair to stand by the age of your hand when you read his story. But he's an 18-year-old, he writes well. And you don't understand, I don't understand why, after reading this, his ability to write, find that he didn't get anything. He was offered matriculation as well. Okay? So, how can I do this? This was supposed to come last, this was the punchline. The punchline comes first. Okay, Dr. Wee said, this is the quote that the Anthony said just now, where MCA itself admitted, you know, Dr. Wee said the situation this year had shocked even him, although the MCA youth chief and party national education bureau chairman had been handling education and scholarship issues since 2001. You know? Okay.